So, this is the hot new product in 3D printing right now. It's the E3D Hemera. It's the Hemera. It's a hotend extruder combo that I think does pretty much everything right. So, let's check out what's new and what's different compared to what else is out there. Okay, the biggest and most obvious new thing with Hemera is that it really is intended to be used in combination with the included V6 hot side. It also comes with a heater and a thermistor, obviously. In fact, you can only buy it with the V6 hot side included or as a Bowden version, which is just taking out that hot side and the Hemera specific heat break and replacing it with a Bowden adapter, aka the Bowdapter, and you also obviously don't need the fan anymore. But the nice thing is, instead of having, you know, an extruder body that you use with a hot end and a separate stepper motor, it's all combined into one group of parts. Let me take this one apart real quick. There we go. The front plate of the extruder is also the heatsink for the hot end, and the stepper motor's front and back covers do double duty as the back plate of the extruder and as mounting points on the side. That makes it super compact as a unit, but it also shortens the filament path between the extruder gears and the nozzle by quite a bit. That helps extruder precision. There's less wiggle room for the filament in here for it just to coil up or compress and act as a spring, which compared to an average extruder lets you lower retractions slightly, gives you more accurate extrusion, but it also lowers friction, which you really need for flexibles. And it does eat through flexibles like a champ. There's no way the filament could escape to simply because you have that Hemera specific heat break that goes right up to the extruder's gears, and that's flanked by the aluminum housing on both sides. And yes, it does have extruder gears, three of them. The pinion on the motor shaft right here, the first extruder shaft with a larger spur gear for that 3-to-1 reduction from the motor, the hob section, and a second spur gear to transfer the torque to the second extruder shaft, Bondtech style. By the way, there's a nice little idler bushing in here on the idler, and it does spin really well. This is all pretty well miniaturized stuff. I mean, that first extruder shaft is just pretty much crammed full of parts, and the reduction gears look pretty minuscule, and... Oh wow, is that a crack on the gear? Yeah, this one is messed up, and I've only used this Hemera so far for a few kilograms of PLA. But this is the pre-production Hemera unit, and the exact issue where this pinion was cracking was discovered and fixed before the retail units were produced. So yeah, that's why you do testing with your products before you ship them. Anyways, so the extruder part is basically a Bondtech BMG. I don't know which hop profile the BMG uses exactly, but the one in the Hemera is really close to an M3 thread, but of course without the thread pitch. That's on the fine side, which means there's going to be little to no pulsation from something like a coarser spur gear chunking against the filament as it rotates, but I've also found finer hobbing to have less of a self-cleaning effect that if you ever strip your filament from a clogged hotend or messed up print settings, those shavings may not fall out on their own again. But then again, with a dual drive extruder, you're probably never going to end up with stripped filament anyways. And honestly, I don't even remember when I last stripped filament, even with a single gear extruder. E3D also say that before running out of grip on the filament or breaking these finer spur gears for the reduction, the motor itself should run out of torque and just skip a step. I hope I remember that correctly. Speaking of the motor, the one that's included, well, not included, but built into the Hemera, is a compact size one. It looks bigger and heavier than it is because it has these chunky front and back plates on it, but I've still not managed to run out of torque with it, either with the normal V6 hot side or with the Super Volcano, even printing beyond what would be considered reasonable speeds. A lot of you have already asked for a pancake version of Hemera. I guess that might be inspired by my E3D Titan review from back in the day where I specifically used a pancake motor with the Titan and got a perfectly usable lightweight setup. With the Hemera, I believe you could swap the end plates onto a normal NEMA 17 stepper, But the shaft of the Hemera's motor is turned down and has that pinion gear pressed on it. So that right now keeps you from using your own motors, and we'll have to wait whether E3D actually release a pancake version sometime in the future. Currently, it weighs in at 381 grams, including the hot side, fans, wires, all that. The Enit A8's stock extruder and hotend were 397 grams. That one does not have any gearing and is only a one-sided drive extruder. And E3D's previous Titan clocked in at about 366 grams, so a few grams lighter than the Hemera. And while the Titan was geared down, it was not a dual drive unit, but the motor I used on here is already of a very comparable core size to what's used on Hemera. The motor on the stock A8 extruder is a bit larger though. So weight-wise, it's par for the course. It's not super light because a lot of the parts are made from metal, but it's also not extraordinarily heavy. When it comes to how you can mount it to your specific printer, you get M3 nuts on two sides of the Hemera. For most printers, that works really well. I've made mounts for the Raptor 2.0 and for the Enit A8. There's also mounts for a ton of other printers already available, thanks to E3D actually reaching out and sponsoring people to create these mounts and full mod guides. 3D Maker Noob has done a bunch of them, and yes, the Enit A8 guide I did was also sponsored, but I guess I don't need to point this out. But this review right here is entirely my own experience with and my opinion on Hemera. So, why don't we get to some of the points that I wish were better? Okay, first off, the heatsink and the fan that cool the... You stay here. That cool the hotend. Typically, you know, this is one of these blue fan shrouds that kind of blows air perpendicular to the bed. But the fin structure on Hemera was designed specifically to kick air up and away from the bed and the nozzle. Now, while that's great for printing hotter materials that want as little airflow as possible on the print itself, it also means that when Hemera is mounted like this, as you're standing in front of the printer, it blows right into your face and your eyes when you're standing in front of the machine. I guess a little air shield up here that funnels air upwards could fix that. Next, the tension adjustment. So, they've got this really cool injection molded idler lever in here, and you can really tell that E3D have learned a lot about injection molding since their first dabs into it with that V6 fan shroud. So, it's got this slidey ramp setup that, as you tighten this screw up top, it actually pushes out this white bit to the side and increases tension on the idler spring. And it's a mechanism that does work well, but there is no indicator of how tight you actually want to set it. Titan had this little peephole up here that showed you how much tension you're putting on the filament. On other extruders, for example, the Mark III's, you at least see the point where a screw is flush with something, and that gives you some reference. But here it's just, you know, this white bit maybe being flush with the black bit at some point, or you can count turns from the screw bottoming out. But there's no easy way to tell what level of tension you're at. I don't know, at least have some steps in this white bit that indicate a few different tension levels when they're flush with the black surface here. And lastly, it's yet another proprietary set of parts for the extruder. I know there's no way around that. If you want to advance performance, you kind of need to cut some ties. But yeah, the entire stepper motor is now a proprietary part, as is the new heat brake. Let me take this one out real quick. That is another Hemera-only part. For now, let's see if this style... Get out of here. There we go. Let's see if this style gets adopted for more setups, because really, I don't see any reason why the old V6 heatbrake would still need to exist. Actually, when it comes to thermals, the Hemera heatbrake should outperform the V6 one, since the heat needs to travel through less stainless steel outwards. So, are these strong arguments against the Hemera? No, it's details. E3D definitely do know what they're doing, and I think they've achieved what seems to have been the two main improvements over the Titan line of extruders. First, to make it more compact, and that definitely happened, especially because now there's nothing sticking out from the sides and nothing that needs to be... accessible from the sides. So you can mount it flush both ways, or you can even put several Hemera extruders right next to each other. And it looks like there's a mirrored version coming too. The front plate already has all the holes and stuff provisioned for that. And the other goal was price. Now, that was achieved by integrating everything into singular, albeit proprietary, die-cast parts and just straight up bundling a V6 hot side and a motor with it. And honestly, I feel really bad for Bondtech. They were the ones pioneering dual-drive extruders, and now E3D come in and they're just better at making the same level extruder for much, much cheaper. So, I've taken the prices of MetaHackers because they carry everything, so I have some comparable prices. All the links are in the video description below. The Hemera kit, everything included that you see here, is $120, well, $119.99. But that is more expensive than the $99 that the Bondtech BMG is currently selling for. But with that, you still need a motor, which you can bundle for an extra $15, and you need a hotend. The BMG is just the extruder itself, and a regular V6 hotend is another $59. So that leaves the Bondtech BMG costing basically 50% more for a comparable setup parts-wise, but it's got a much longer filament path because you have the V6 dangling down there. And of course, that also means it is physically a much longer setup, and probably heavier too. I don't know, I've not measured it. I mean, that makes it kind of tough to recommend the BMG at this point. You know, the BMG used to be the benchmark for compact, lightweight, high performance, but I think it's found its match. E3D have done an excellent job with Hemera. With the Hemera? I never know how to say that. Not just with the product itself, but also with having official mounts, firmwares, and guides ready to go for all the popular printers basically on launch day. This, right now, if it had all the parts in here, is the setup to beat. From what I've seen performance-wise, like actually printing with the Hemera, it's flawless. This thing never skipped a beat. Now, I haven't measured how much force these extruders can exert on the filament exactly. Let me know if that's still something you'd like to see benchmarked. But really, if any extruder is going to compete with the Hemera right now, it's going to have to be on price, maybe on form factor, but not on performance. Hey, and one quick favor to ask, could you check if you're subscribed? Because I still see that a third of you are watching and apparently liking my videos, but you're not subscribed. Now, YouTube isn't even going to do much based on that subscription unless you also set whether or not you want to see notifications. You can do that by clicking the bell and choosing, well, whatever setting you like. So, thank you for subscribing, and also a big thank you to all my awesome patrons and YouTube members. On YouTube right now, you can join for $5 a month, and that gives you access to supporter-only Q&A hangouts. There are more tiers on Patreon, like the shouter tier, where I'm currently being supported by the following awesome folks. That's Christopher Day, Dorian Gray, Phyllis Suter, Haytham Benani, Hussein Karatas, James C. Foley, Jeffrey Nikolajic, Jimmy Lee, Jonathan Madden, Lunicorn X64, Marcus Harms, Matthew Oswald, Mike McGee, Olivares, Paul Arden, Printed Solid, and Robert Hornberg, as well as William Devine. And let's not forget Adam Green, Philip Gawk, James Koch, Kurt Wibbles, Make Tech, Neil Youngberg, NM Creator, and Robert Baum. All the links to Patreon, etc. are listed below. Again, thank you so much to everyone who is and has been making this channel possible, and thank you all for watching. I will see you in the next one.